Hi everyone, welcome back. This video we are going to study open shortest path first protocol, which is implemented in intra-domain system, which is actually based on link state routing algorithm. So in link state routing algorithm, we need to find the least cost when a packet is to be transmitted from source to destination using Dijkstra's algorithm, the least cost tree. That is, when to forward a packet from source to destination, the least cost value, the path is actually determined. So OSPF, the metric we use here in OSPF, open shortest path first, is the cost. The metric actually assigned as the weight, that is based on throughput, round trip time and reliability and some other parameters. And the least cost is actually determined based on link state routing protocol that it implements Dijkstra's algorithm. Here in this diagram, four networks are shown. Four networks, N1, N2, N3 and N4 are shown. And the metric cost to every networks are shown here as in numerical values. So when a packet is to be transmitted from source to the destination network, that is N4. At router 1, the cost is calculated as 12. Total cost is 12. That is, the packet will travel through the network N2, N3 and finally reach the destination N4. The cost of N2, N3, N4 is 5 plus 3 plus 4. That is 12. And while calculating the cost, the source network is not included because it is generating and transmitting the data. The same way, the cost at R2 is of network N3 and N4. That is 3 plus 4. That is 7. And cost at router 3 is 4. So the routers in intra-domain networks have to prepare their forwarding table where to guide a packet to forward further to reach the destination. In link state routing algorithm, first the routers are actually preparing that adjacent neighbor details, the network information with the adjacent neighbor nodes, and they flood the information throughout the network so that the topology of the network can be known by every routers. And finally, when the system is stabilized, all routers are updating their forwarding table. See, for example, in forwarding table of R2, so this is router 2 having the forwarding table. So the mandatory fields to be there in the forwarding table are, the first column we should have the network destination address and what is the next router the packet has to travel through and the total cost to reach the destination. It is similar to RIP protocol, that is routing information protocol, rather number of hosts. Here we have cost actually. So for a packet to travel from router 2 and to reach the destination N1, say network 1, the packet has to travel through router 1. So next router is router 1, destination here is N1, and next router is router 1, and the cost is calculated as 5 plus 4, that is 9. So this is how routers are preparing the forwarding table when the system is stabilized. In OSPF, the autonomous systems are actually partitioned into different areas. See, several areas. Why? We have seen in the routing information protocol, number of hops, that is number of routers can be connected, is limited to 15 numbers. That is, maximum 15 hops can be connected in a network. Above that, the count 16 is actually meant to infinite. So RIP is implemented in smaller networks only, but OSPF can be, the protocol can be implemented in larger networks. The concept here in OSPF is, it is following link state routing algorithm. So the routers are flooding the information throughout the nodes so that all nodes in the network will have to have the knowledge about the entire topology, and the link state database is prepared from the flooding information through which the least cost tree for the source to destination is determined. And because flooding the information to prepare link state database in case of larger network system, that creates a huge traffic and that makes the system complex. To prevent the complexity and to reduce the traffic, the networks are actually grouped into several areas, and all areas are named to identify themselves. So the names area 1, area 2 and area 0 are the identification of different areas. See, according to link state database algorithm, The nodes are actually flooding the information. So the networks and router in area 1, not only knowing the information about area 1, and those networks have to know the information from the networks of another areas. So one of the area in the autonomous system is actually made as backbone area. So the router in the backbone area is generally called backbone router, and this backbone router is responsible for collecting and sending the information from one area to another area, so that all networks in all areas will have the information about total network systems. Here area border router is connecting different areas, and information between all different areas are actually communicated through the backbone router connected in backbone area. And the AS boundary router, that is autonomous system boundary router, is responsible to share and collect the information to and from other autonomous system outside. So in order to collect a link state database, the routers, as soon as the system started, initially they collect the information with adjacent nodes, then they flood the information. In order to flood the information, they advertise themselves. That is, the information network address are actually advertised by router to their adjacent nodes. When we studied the link state routing algorithm in the previous lecture series, we have seen nodes are actually representing the router, and the edge in between routers are actually of networks, and the cost is given. But actually in real-time system, when we go and implement OSPF using this link state routing algorithm, not only considering nodes as a router, this will also consider networks as a node. That is, different nodes are to be considered and different links between nodes are to be considered. Here in OSPF, the links are actually categorized into router link, network link, and summary link to network, summary link to autonomous system, and external link. So these links are actually used to advertise the network information. Here in router link, the link advertises the existence of a router as a node. So the routers are actually represented as a node, and three links we have: point to point, stub link, and transient link. So the point to point link is actually between two routers, and the stub link, the local area network, is connected to the router. So the information that is to the network and from the network is actually communicated through this connected network only. And the transient link is actually when a network system has several routers connected to it. So here these links are actually defining the address of the routers to neighbors. And next in network link, the network is considered as nodes, and network cannot advertise itself the information. So one of the router connected to the network is termed as a designated router, and the designated router will advertise the information to other nodes. Here, and a summary link to a network, actually this is done by area border router that is connecting different areas, and it is advertising the summary of links collected by backbone areas. And next, summary link to AS, this is done by an AS router, that is autonomous system router, and advertising the summary links from other autonomous systems. So these are the links we have in OSPF to advertise the network information to other nodes, as other networks. And in order to implement OSPF, the message format is to be understood. The message format in OSPF is somewhat complex than routing information protocol. Here we have a common header, a OSPF common header, and link state general header. And along with this, the five different packets are to be followed when we implement OSPF. And the first field says the version and which type of protocol is actually we have, and next 16 bits are of message length. So which router is actually forwarding a packet, the source router IP address, and area identification. Area identification we have seen, area 0, 1, 2, 3 are the identification for the area, and the checksum for error detection, and the authentication type. Yes, to prevent a forwarding packet, that the packet is not to be forwarded to not designated network system. Yes, if there is an authentication, the information will come in this field, authentication field. So this is the common header, and these ETR of flags, these are the general information we have in header of OSPF. Five different types of messages are to be followed when we implement OSPF in real-time system, that is in intra-domain. And along with these headers, the hello message, when the system is started and routers are preparing their information along with the adjacent nodes. And initially, the router sends hello message to router 2. That router 1 says, I know about you, and sharing the information. And the response to the message hello sent by R1, the response by R2 is actually of the database description message. That is to allow a newly joined router to acquire the full link state database. And if router needs any link state information, that will send a request. Actually, link state request message is sent to the router, and link state update message is the main open shortest path first message used for building link state database. After all information, that is when the request comes and the response done, and link state acknowledgement message is of reliability, that is when a router is receiving a link state update message, that is database information is collected and that router has to acknowledge for the information collected. So along with the common header files, OSPF implementation is actually followed with all these five messages, and these fields are actually of the five packets we process, five different types of messages we use to implement OSPF, and these are the format for all different five messages. So the OSPF is actually following link state routing algorithm. In link state routing algorithm, what do we do? Generally, there is flooding information when the link state database has to be prepared. So once the database is done, it uses Dijkstra's algorithm to find shortest path, that is least cost tree is prepared. And after each router has created the shortest path tree, the algorithm needs to use it to create corresponding routing algorithm. One additional things we have in OSPF algorithm is in order to implement OSPF, we need to go with all five types of messages. So in OSPF, the cost, the metric is actually of cost, and cost is assigned in each and every links that is in the network, and it uses link state routing algorithm, that is with the help of Dijkstra's algorithm, the shortest path for this packet to transmit from source to destination is determined. And it is implemented in intra-domain network system. Thank you.